Good afternoon, sports fans, and welcome to the Sports Express. I'm your host, Alonzo, and we're going to jump right in with our topic today, and that's the upcoming NFL 2014 season. Now, if you take a look around the league, there have been a lot of free agent signings and draft picks, and another exciting year is looming upon us. As a matter of fact, it's September 7th, where the season will be starting. So I want to kind of take a look at some of the teams and some of my picks and to inform you that I will be making some of my, each Friday, I'll be putting my picks in. Well, on Thursday, actually, when my show is available to you, I'll be giving my picks for that week with the NFL. And I'm going to be keeping a kind of a record to make sure that I'm staying on top of sports and just seeing how good I am as far as like my prediction and my one loss record. I look forward to that. It's going to be real exciting. I'm going to make my prediction before I start talking about a couple other teams throughout the league. I still feel, in my opinion, that in the NFC it's going to be the Seattle Seahawks or the San Francisco 49ers that's going to represent the NFC in the Super Bowl this year. I mean, because if you take a look at a couple of plays, San Francisco would have been that last year if you take Kaepernick not throwing that interception at the end of the game to Sherman. He picked the wrong time to throw to the best, one of the best corners in the NFL. So you take that play away, and we're talking about San Francisco that just left the Super Bowl. But nevertheless, Seattle went and they won, and they won convincingly against Denver. Denver just never seen it coming. You've never seen a defense that disciplined and ready to play that I've ever seen. I mean, they just completely shut down Denver in all phases of the game. I mean, if you notice one thing about Denver offense is Peyton kind of looked like a deer in headlights, and the receivers' arms started to get shorter as the game went on, even the slots as well, the slot receivers as well. So hopefully those kinks is out, and because I believe that Denver will be the representative for the AFC this year. I just think they're just as stacked again, and they've made some off-season acquisitions that I think will put them right where they need to be. But Peyton only have a small window left of playing in the NFL. I think 2 or 3 years, if that. And I'm being generous when I say 3. But I think that he's clearly showing you he can get it done. Now, unfortunately, during the big game playoffs, he has not been as good. And I'm hoping that he can turn that around this year and hoist that trophy at the end of the year. And if he does, I think that he will retire because he'll have really nothing to play for. But let's just dive in when we look at the NFC. You take a look at the Eagles. The Eagles have a 10-6 season. Foles, you know, we got to see if he's going to be the real deal or another Reggie Cobb. I mean, another Kevin Cobb. LeSean McCoy, he's going to be doing his thing. He's going to be getting some help now with Sproles back there. Now, their receiver's not as deep with DeSean Jackson defecting to the Washington Redskins, which I think that's going to level out the Washington Redskins, because now RG3, he got a receiver that will stretch out the field now. He's going to keep those cornerbacks honest and the defense honest, and the running back in the back, I think that he's going to see way more yardage per carry now because DeSean Jackson's out there stretching out that field. Dallas Cowboys, I just have one word. Romo is not the answer. I'm sorry. He's not an Aikman and Starbucks jockstrap. Romo is a good, solid quarterback, but I'm sorry, I just don't think that he's going to be an NFL leader in terms of taking him to a Super Bowl. I just don't think that he has that knack. Not yet. I mean, he's had so much time to do it, he hasn't done it. And Jerry Jones, if that man just get out of the way, he's had some great coaches, but unfortunately, he wants people to know that he owned that team, and he's on Achilles' heel to that team. They are in disarray. And with them having management like they do, and his yes men, and Jerry Jones just keep his nose stuck in it, he is going to have a problem. He should have drafted Manziel, at least to have him as a backup to Romo as a future prodigy. I mean, but he did it to, he wanted to pacify Romo and don't want him to feel threatened, but he should feel threatened. Maybe that'll force him to up his game. So you need to look at Dallas, but I don't think Dallas is going to be doing much of anything. You look at the NFC South, I think New Orleans is going to run away with that. The Falcons, I didn't understand that season. Ryan them had a completely different season than they had before, the year before. They had an awful season last year. I think Ryan them, they're going to get that back together. Steven Jackson, hopefully he have a better season. Roddy White, I think that the Falcons still have the pieces to compete in the NFC South. The Carolina Panthers, Cam Newton again. But he don't have a whole lot of major weapons around him. So I think that with Cam Newton, they have a chance. But I don't know. That's something to be seen. Now if you take a look in the NFC North, it's pretty good. Detroit, you know, you got Megatron. Stafford, you know, he's a former Georgia University quarterback. But he hasn't shown that he can show up in the big games yet. He's good for stats, but he hasn't led them to where you can, they've signed him to a longer term deal, but I just still think that they're missing something. You know, I think Bush addition is really good. Bush is having one of his best years. He had one of his best years last year from an overall standpoint. So I think Detroit is going to be a force in that division. Minnesota, they're still trying to sort out their quarterback situation. Bridgewater, you know, he looked pretty good in the preseason. But we're going to see if he's going to be able to unseat Ponders. You know, Ponders had a up and down season last year. And Bridgewater got to prove that he can lead them down the field with Adrian Peterson. I still think that they will be competitive, though. But I can't really tell you where I think that they'll be. I think they will somewhat be in the middle of the pack, but I can't really say that for sure. Green Bay, Aaron Rodgers. You got Aaron Rodgers, you got a chance. That man right there, he reminds me a lot of Phillip Rivers, that he does a lot with little. You know, those two right there are bulldog quarterbacks. I love them to death. So I look forward to that. Chicago, Brandon Marshall, Cutler. Cutler has to become a leader, a better leader. He just does. They have a defense that's always solid. But I think they're still missing some pieces. But I still think that's going to be, the NFC North is going to be real competitive. Let's take a look at the AFC. Kansas City, they had a great year, but Reed has shown that he'll do that. He did it in Philadelphia, but you have to win a big game. For him to have the record he had and get kicked out the first round, that was just awful. But I think that they still have a chance to beat that division. But I still think Denver's going to win that division. I think San Diego is going to get them around for the money because they got Phillip Rivers. I love Phillip Rivers. I just can't speak enough about this guy. If he was ever go to Dallas or a place like that, I think that he would take them to the Super Bowl. I just have that kind of... A couple years ago, some years back when they got rid of Breeze when he was with San Diego, I kind of had a problem with that because I felt like they should have kept Breeze and got rid of Rivers. But I changed my mind. I'm a true believer. I'm a true believer now. I'm a true Rivers fan. Now, Breeze is still a great quarterback down there in New Orleans, and they had a great pick when they took him to New Orleans because he won them Super Bowl. I think you take Rivers and put him in New Orleans, I think that they would want Super Bowl too. You just had two great quarterbacks. So let's keep our eyes on those two as they come up through the NFL season. Now, in the AFC Central, Pittsburgh, they had a better signing free agency this year than they've had in the past couple of years. I still think that Ben Roethlisberger, I think he's going to need a protege to back him up to start the groom for the future because they're talking about an extension for Roethlisberger, but I still believe that they need to get a grooming quarterback because he got some mileage on him, but Ben is still Ben. They got some good acquisitions on defense and offense. I think it's going to better them. They have a young receiving core. A good friend of mine's, I spoke to her about it, Stephanie. She's a statistic whiz. She knows her football, and she feels that they have a young core that is going to be a learning curve. But her and I both think they're still going to be competitive this year. Cincinnati. They signed Dalton to a new signing extension. I think that he's taken them to the playoffs for each of the past few years, but I think he's gonna have to reach up and go even further if Cincinnati want to be really considered a contender in that division. Cleveland, a big mess. just a big hot mess. Manziel, they just still they don't know who the starter gonna be. Hoyer, he's okay, I guess. Manziel, he's gonna have to learn the NFL is not Texas A&M anymore. You're not in college anymore. You know, those antics that you were able to do as far as like, you know, he's a talent. And he's able to run out, just run out the pocket and make these little flashy plays. He's gonna have to learn that he can make it in the NFL. But now you got defensive linemen that can run from one sideline to the other on that 4-3 speed. The level of the speed has picked up another notch. So Manziel gonna have to learn on the curve. He's gonna have to learn at warp speed that this is the NFL, it's not college anymore. Just, you know, he was used to a spread offense that they had. And most spread offenses give defensive coordinators headaches. But in the NFL, they plan for you week in and week out. And just, he's just going to realize, like I just said, he's looking at a whole different breed of faster players. So Cleveland, once they get their situation together, I think that they'll be okay. But I don't think they're going to be competing at least the next two seasons. New England, Miami, New York Jets. They're, to me, that neck and neck. New England, they got Tom Brady along. They have Tom Brady. They have a chance. Miami, they have a real good defense. Tannehill, you know, he's coming into his own. So, look out for Miami to make some noise during the season. I think that they're gonna surprise a lot of people this year. The New York Jets, Geno Smith is the man. Vic is backing him up. I think Vic time has came and gone. But he can be a good mentor to Geno Smith. I think Geno Smith, once he learned how to read coverage just a little better, I think he's going to be good. Rex Ryan, he stayed. I thought he was going to be gone, but he stayed around. And he's still there, and he's doing pretty good. He's working what he got. He have a real good I still think they shouldn't have got rid of Revis. I like Revis. But I think Revis is going to be good for them down in Tampa. And I look forward to seeing Revis play. But I think the Jets is going to be competitive. I think they're going to be competitive. So I look forward to seeing what the Jets have to offer this year. Now, to close it out, I'm looking at the Indianapolis Colts in the AFC South. The Indianapolis Colts with Andrew Luck, product out of Stanford. When they had made that transition from Peyton Manning to Luck, they lucked out. No pun intended. They lucked out really good. He's been pretty solid. And he's done better than what I expected him to do. He's led them to win a season, each one of his seasons in the NFL. And I think that they found them a franchise quarterback. And I think they need to surround him with some more pieces with outside of Reggie Wayne and a couple of other players that they have. I think that their defense is becoming solid every year. But they need to add some more pieces. And I think that they'll run that division for years to come. Houston, a big mess. Johnson is their best quality player on offense. Watts is their best player, in my opinion, on defense. Watts is there, and they're going to sign him to a long-term extension if they haven't already. So I had to take a look and do some research and see how they have, because the last time they were at an impasse. Johnson, I think he won out of Houston. I just think that he sees a sinking ship, and he just won out of there. He still has some years left on him. He's a big, solid, formidable wide receiver, so he'll help out some other team if they decide to pick him up. As I was saying, I'm looking forward to this NFL season. I've been having a hangover from last year, and I'm ready for them to kick it off and get this thing going. I don't put too much stock in the preseason because I think the preseason is just that. You have a couple, you know, they're playing a couple series in the first, second quarter, and then the rest of the guys who's trying to win the job, then those are the guys that play. So you can't really put much stock in this preseason. Most people don't remember records in preseason anyway, because they don't mean anything. But I do look forward to this season. I'll be making my picks every week, and you'll be getting them right here on Lonzo Says Show, as well as on my website. So I look forward to that. Please give me feedback. Give me show ideas for this Sports Express, because I have a whole bunch of old show ideas, but I love to have feedback. My show is still new, it's raw. I'm still learning my way. I know it's going to take me time to get subscribers, but I hope that by the end of the year, next year, I'm at a different plateau than I am now, but I'm looking forward to diving right in. My set will change by then. It will be a whole another transition, but I'm going to continue to keep the same raw, uncompromising topics that we're going to speak about every week. So from everybody here at the Sports Express this week, I'm going to say hello, have a wonderful day, take care, God bless, and I look forward to speaking to you again here on the Sports Express with the Alonzo. Take care. Bye-bye.